Of all the Android launch devices, the Nexus One will always hold a special place in my heart. That's not to take anything away from my first Android device, the HTC G1, that launched Android to the world with its distinctive chin and slide-out keyboard. Or the HTC Magic, the first pre-release Android phone I got to dog food when I joined Google, and the first of the wave of devices we gave every attendee starting at Google I.O. in 2009. 2010 was the year Android went from, that's interesting, to global phenomenon, growing from 100,000 activations a day in May to over 300,000 by December. That was seriously helped by the release of the Motorola Droid. I can still remember the offices here in Building 44 echoing with the constant refrain of Droid as each device rebooted. The Droid was the first of the thinner, higher res, more powerful Android devices that have since become standard. And it was also the device whose release on Verizon here in the US really kicked off the flood of Android activations. But I was a Londoner then, and the Droid was a CDMA-only phone, so it was never really a device I truly used. Then there was the Nexus One, codenamed Passion, the first device I felt was pure Android. It was also the phone we brought with us on our 2010 Android Developer Labs World Tour. Me and my colleagues traveled across the world, 7 cities in 10 days, introducing over 20,000 developers to Android by way of presentations and a free Nexus One. As a result, I made a lot of friends across Europe and learned exactly how many boxes of phones I can carry across snowdrifts in Stockholm and icy roads in Berlin. Since then, the Nexus S, 4 and 5 have each improved on what it takes to make a great Android phone, and OEMs across the world have created thousands of different Android devices, starting with the Motorola Zoom, which led Android's official expansion into tablets, and leading the way for the Nexus 7 and 10. But that was just the start. Those changes paved the way for the Android mobile OS to grow until it could be the brains behind anything from phones and tablets to TVs, cars, and wearables, like Android Wear. It's impossible to know what comes next. Who knows? Maybe the next Android devices will be Androids themselves.